Baby is.
She's fine. She's small, but she's strong.
I've changed. Frank, I'm still changing.
I love you, Denise.
I love you too, Frank.
It's an Army outpatient rehab program, but they can help. Please?
It's a rental overlooking the harbor. Thinking about taking it for a week. Just need some time away, you know, to think about where I want to go, what I want to do next.
Well, you should do it. Is this Tim?
Yes, it is. Roses are beautiful, aren't they?
This isn't the man I want to be. This isn't the father I want to be. I need help, Rox. I need real help.
Call the police right now.
What? Why?
That guy who's talking to you over there, he's a stalker.
Hey!
We'd like for you all to meet our daughter, Sarah Elizabeth.
Hello, Sarah Elizabeth.
Mama. Her hands. They're so small. Honey, you just missed it. She grabbed my finger.
Actually grabbed it?
Yeah.
No, because sometimes her hand kind of moves, but it's not grabbing.
I think it was grabbing. Opposable thumbs, the works.
That's really advanced.
Yeah.
We need to get out more.
Or sleep more.
Yeah.
All of which will be possible when your mother gets here tomorrow. Thank God.
I've never seen you so excited about a visit from her.
I've never had a reason to be so excited about a visit from her.
Yeah. And you'd think being a shrink, the physician could heal himself.
It's never that easy. Honey, just relax. And enjoy the visit.
I'll write myself that prescription.
She definitely grabbed. They're hot.
Thanks.
And technically not for you, but help yourself.
Who are they technically for?
Colonel Connor's wife, Jennifer, who arrives on post today. I was gonna pay her a visit tomorrow. I'll give her a day to settle in.
Should I just give up on ever trying to get ahead of you?
Probably. But you can brief me on her. All I know is her name and when she arrives.
She's a lawyer, so the two of you will have plenty to talk about. Given her profession, she has to be smart, so she'll fall right into your crowd.
Speaking of the crowd, we're all going to Denise's tonight. She's back from her little break.
How's she doing?
It's tough on her. Frank and Jeremy both being deployed.
I hope she and Frank can get this worked out. He's pretty devastated.
She is, too. Oddly, something she planned.
But it is what she wanted, right?
I think she's mostly confused. And the death hit her pretty hard.
Death?
That doctor over at the hospital, Getty.
What are you talking about?
What were you talking about?
Did she have something going on with that doctor?
Oh, I thought Frank would have told you.
Told me what, Claudia Joy?
They kissed. That's all. It was not an affair.
He's over there risking his life, and you know how I feel about this, Claudia Joy.
I do, and it's their problem, and they're working on it.
It's still a betrayal. Would you consider it just a kiss if it were me?
Why are we going there? It's not about us. Sorry I said anything.
So am I, because it changes my opinion of her.
Have some compassion. She's my friend.
And he's mine. I'm gonna be late.
Where's the welcoming committee?
Hey.
Hello.
Hey. What's going on?
Oh.
Beautiful.
I'm so glad you're home.
Hey. Is there something else?
Yeah, there's something else. I don't know. Should I tell you now?
Yes. What?
Okay. There was this guy, a fan of the radio show, who started stalking me. He was following me, and he was leaving things on the doorstep, and he was taking pictures, and he broke into the house.
What? He broke... Were you here?
Yeah.
Did he hurt you?
No.
What about the kids? Where are the kids? What?
They're fine. They're fine.
Ah.
It's okay. He's in jail now. And I'm okay. I was just scared. And exhausted. I'm so happy that you're home. I'm so glad you're home.
Okay. World history cannot be making you smile like that.
I'm running to Logan.
Do I know Logan?
He's my army pen pal.
Oh.
That thing that you and Dad encouraged me to do.
Mm-hmm. Where is he, Eric?
Yeah, he's in communications. He does a lot of satellite stuff. He says that the only injury that he's gotten is from falling off a ladder. But it was a tall ladder.
He sounds funny.
He reads a lot, too. He likes transcendentalists. I've only read Walden, but I loved it.
You could have a lot to talk about.
Claudia Joy?
Can I help you?
I'm Jennifer Connor, Colonel Connor's wife.
Oh!
Is this a good time?
Sure.
I'm sure it's on your list to come by the house, but I got in last night and packed everything and I'm already bored.
Oh, wow, I can't have that. This is my daughter, Emily.
Wow, aren't you gorgeous? Thank you. Didn't mean to interrupt a mother-daughter moment.
Oh, not at all. I'm sure I was just starting to bug her anyway. Why don't we go inside?
Sure.
We'll be in there, honey. So you got in last night?
Yes, I did.
How did you unpack so quickly?
I have it down to a science. And don't tell anyone. I hire a lot of extra hands. I know a good army wife should do it herself, but I've been delegating too long to stop now.
Michael tells me you're a lawyer.
Yes. Real estate litigation.
Ah, nice.
Evan says you went to law school.
Years ago, back during the witch trials.
I'm sure it's not that different.
No.
Were you interested in a field?
Probably family law. And then I just decided to have one instead.
That's admirable. I'm not sure I have the patience for children.
For you and Evan. I was going to ask you if you're interested in joining our FRG.
Absolutely.
Good.
I was FRG leader at Fort Irwin.
Really? Okay, we have a meeting tomorrow at noon.
I'll be there.
Good.
And thanks for these. Even if your secret plan is to make me fat.
I have no secret plans.
That's refreshing. See you tomorrow.
Okay.
I'll save myself up.
That does not sound like homework. If I have to come in there, you boys are both going to bed early. You can get an incomplete on your assignment and explain that to your teacher. Ow! Ugh.
You all right?
Just your basic Batmobile injury. I'm fine. How's your Dapsy meeting?
It was okay, I guess. I mean, it was my first one, so I didn't really do much talking.
Mm-hmm.
Or any talking. But it helped to listen.
Well, that's great.
Yeah. I mean, the counselor thinks I should go every day for the next couple of weeks. But that's a lot on you, seeing as how I work full time.
Well, it's important, so we'll make it work. How are you feeling?
Just a little bit shaky and tense. Nothing I can't handle. They say that passes pretty quickly, too. They also say that maybe you should get some counseling.
What? Me? Why? What did I do?
Well, you're going through stuff, too.
Don't worry about me. I'm fine. If you want to help, the boys need to finish their homework. I gotta go to Denise's.
No problem. You getting sick?
No. I'm not getting sick. I don't have time to get sick. I told my body that, and it's not gonna talk back.
Well, I wouldn't talk back.
Hon.
Right. Homework.
Lesson Getaway was great. I read a lot. I took some walks. I saw some wildlife I never want to see again. I didn't make any big decisions out there, but I didn't expect to.
It might take more than a week to figure out your whole life.
Yeah.
Here, sweetie.
Thank you.
How's Trevor?
He's in Adapsy, hopefully on the mend.
That's really great.
And you, little miss, I noticed you didn't leave your house at all this morning.
Busted. Chase came home today.
Oh, I thought you seemed a little relaxed.
So what are you doing here?
Well, when he's done with his debriefing, believe me, I won't be.
Oh, I met Jennifer Connor.
Oh, yeah? Really? Do you like her?
Too soon to tell.
What about Frank and Jeremy? Have you heard from them now?
Jeremy's doing okay. Frank and I are just taking it one step at a time. Coming back here is hard. Everything reminds me of something. Thinking about redecorating.
Would Frank be okay with that?
He's always left the house stuff up to me. He would pay attention to how much I spent.
So then you just use your own money.
Yeah, I don't have an account. Well, we've always just blended our money.
Yeah, well, of course, but you've never had your own account?
Well, I'm not Amish. I just got married young. Stop looking at me like that.
I'm sorry.
Okay, I'm making a list.
A what?
A to-do list for becoming the new liberated Denise.
I'm not liberated.
Just modernize. Okay. One.
Mm-hmm.
New bank account.
Yeah.
Two. Redecorate.
Mm-hmm.
Third.
Line dancing.
I thought it was pole dancing.
No dancing.
Okay, oh, I know a tequila shop for us.
It's all right, Sarah. Come on, it's not as bad as all that. Gas prices will go down. You look at what recession is.
Where are my girls?
Working it out in here. Vivian, welcome back. How was your flight?
Long. I sat next to the chatterbox. Woman wanted to tell me her whole life story.
Well, was it interesting at least?
Not a bit. Let me see the baby. Oh, she's beautiful. Hand her over.
Mother, Joan is working it out.
Joan is ready to admit defeat.
Oh. Lonely. You didn't tell me.
Tell you what?
That she has all our cheese, She looks just like our side of the family. I don't see a speck of Joan in her.
I know. If I hadn't delivered her myself, I'd swear somebody mailed her to me.
The Burtons are a delightful bunch, but they are loud. Yes. Now, sweet, go to sleep. You'll have time to express yourself later.
Maybe she's hungry.
I just fed her. I guess she's just cranky.
Yes, that's it, sweetie. Grandma's got you now. If you're nervous, then they get nervous. You have to tell them how it is.
I'm sure Joan knows how to handle the baby, Mother.
She's quieting down.
Whatever works.
That's right.
Yeah. I'll take your things upstairs.
So, okay.
Jennifer's friendly. She's vivacious. A little overpowering, but that never hurt anyone, right? I roped her into FRG right away, I think.
Looking forward to meeting her.
We should take her out to lunch next week.
Yeah, we should. And we should get going because the head of FRG shouldn't be the last to arrive.
Oh, and yet she so often is.
Hey, babe. Thought I'd come home for lunch. I've been craving one of your BLTs.
Oh, you know, Denise and I are just heading out to the FRG meeting.
I'll just forage in the fridge for something.
Hey, Michael.
Hey, Denise. How's Frank doing?
Frank is fine.
I'm gonna get something later on, all right?
I guess he had his heart set on that BLT. We better get going. Ready?
Hey. Hey. So I'm here. Are you ready?
For what?
The FRG meeting. We talked about this.
Oh, God, I forgot. I've just been so busy with all this inventory stuff. Besides, I have to pick the boys up from school.
I thought Trevor usually does that.
Yeah, usually, but he had to rearrange his schedule for all the Adaptium meetings. He has to go to one every day for 2 weeks.
Wow, so you really can't go, huh?
No, and I wish I could. I really want to meet Colonel Connor's wife. Will you fill me in?
Yeah, of course. And Rose.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Are you sick?
No. I cannot get sick.
Should I be worried about you?
No, I'm fine. Just take really good mental notes. And tell me everything.
Okay. I will. I'll see you.
Okay.
I mean, I'm a soldier. I'm taught that I can handle anything. The drugs, they helped at first. But then they started to take over. And out of nowhere, I stopped. And they began.
War-related injuries affect us all in different ways. And part of the problem is that your partners, your family, cannot always understand what you've been through. Specialist LeBlanc, you'd like to share?
I think more than anything, I feel ashamed. Ashamed for getting wounded, ashamed for not being with my unit, ashamed for getting hooked on the pills.
Shame is a powerful emotion, and one we have to learn to overcome.
It's hard.
It's all hard. But that's why we're here. To help make it easy on each other.
Oh, goodness. It's okay, baby girl. Hey, it's okay. Come on.
What's the matter with her?
She's just a little fussy.
She has gas.
No, I burped her, changed her, everything. She's probably tired.
Well, if she has gas, she needs to burp.
I told you I burped her. How you doing?
Let me.
Mother.
Yeah. Come on, precious.
Mother,
one.
She doesn't need to. Mother.
Come on.
You just. Okay.
Uh-oh. Very good. Very nice. She needed a mother's touch.
I would have figured it out eventually.
Roland, it's tradition. Time-tested. A father earning a living. A mother raising the children.
Really? You worked?
I had to when your father died.
And mother, I do earn a living. There's more than one way to support people.
Yeah, but what about your fancy education? You're a doctor teaching school. I mean, what happened to all your ambition?
My ambition is to help raise my child. Mother, Joan and I have a plan. We put a lot of thought into how to do this. Now, if you're just going to criticize, that's not helpful.
Yeah. Oh, it's okay. Come on, my baby. Yes, she does.
Thank you, Elaine, for catching us up on our treasury. As we can see, there's room for improvement in our fundraising department. So the floor is open. Oh, allow me to introduce Jennifer Connor, a recent addition to our post. Her husband, Evan Connor, is Lieutenant Colonel here at Fort Marshall.
Welcome. You'll all get to know me pretty soon, because I don't have Shrinking Violet in my DNA. I've been listening to this discussion, and I'd like to introduce an idea which worked really well when I was FRG leader at Fort Irwin.
Great. Go ahead.
We did a calendar of hot army wives. It's not exactly a pinup, more like glamour shots. The guys loved it, and we made lots of money. From looking around, I can tell we have a few viable candidates.
Not a bad idea. Maybe we could make it a little more relevant.
What do you mean?
I'm sure the men who are deployed would love a visual reminder of their lives here on post. Maybe a slice of life kind of thing. Group shots and candids, men and women, various locations around the post. Snapshots of how life goes on while they're away.
Wow, that's sexy.
I admit it's not exactly going to steam up anybody's windows, but it feels more like what FRG is about.
Let's take a vote.
Okay.
Glamour calendar. Slice of life calendar. So, tradition wins the day.
Congratulations.
Thank you for the idea. Okay, who knows a photographer?
Doing?
Tired. Happy. A little bit of everything.
I'm sure you heard this, but everything gets easier.
Well, right now, the women are in control, and I'm running errands.
That's right. Your mother's visiting. How's that going?
She and Joan and Sarah Elizabeth have completely bonded.
And that's a good thing, right?
I have a lot of unresolved history with my mother.
Garden variety or something interesting?
No, it's pretty classic stuff. She wanted me to go to college, and now she doesn't think I'm doing enough with my fancy education. Mothers raise kids, fathers work, so the way Joan and I are doing things is completely backwards. It's like anything that's modern is wrong. Exhibit A.
Check for $20 made out to Sarah Elizabeth.
She wants me to open a college fund for her.
Well, that's sweet.
She wouldn't let me do it online because she doesn't trust that process. She wants me to hand it to the teller and then come back with proof that I was here.
Well, I'm not that many steps ahead of her. You know what I'm doing?
What?
I'm opening up a new checking account in my own name.
Wow. That's a milestone.
I know. I got married young.
You need any help with those forms?
Thanks. I think I've got all the big words figured out.
No, seriously, congratulations. How about after this, I take you for an ice cream sundae?
I'll take you and I'll pay with a check.
Oh, aren't you sweet? Yeah. You need your driver's license for that. Do you have... Okay, joke stop then.
Thank you.
Go, go!
Hey, babe.
Hey.
Can I ask your opinion on something?
Shoot.
The FRG is putting together a calendar for fundraising. It's nothing sexy. Just life on post, you know, for guys who are deployed. Group shots and stuff like that. And I have been invited to participate.
I don't know, babe. Everything that's happened, maybe you should lay low for a bit. The voice is out there every day, and maybe it's not smart to put your face to it.
Yeah.
What?
Nothing. It's just sad I can't be a part of things.
You are a part of things. You just don't have to be on a poster.
All right. Ladder up.
Hello, ladies. Everybody miss me?
Hi, honey. Then what'd you do?
Well, he wouldn't get off the bus with all these people staring at us. So I was holding his hand, dragging him a little. When... he shouts as loud as can be, "Go ahead, break my arm like you did before."
Where did he hear that?
I don't know, TV or something.
I think she made this story up. I don't remember it. Sometimes when she tells it, it was my brother.
Oh, no, it wasn't Calvin. It was you. The troublemaker. Calvin was too scared to talk back. No, this is the one who had the fire in him. Did you open the account?
Yes. Here's the information.
Thanks.
It's really sweet of you, Vivian. Thank you.
Oh, it's the least I can do. She deserves the same education you had. Maybe she'll go to medical school and actually practice medicine.
Mm-hmm.
No. We just quieted her down.
Yeah, she was crying a lot, babe.
Right. I'll go find some manly work to do.
That's a good idea. Your washing machine has a knocking sound.
So I think I'm gonna paint the walls too. You know, just a deeper color to warm things up.
Yeah, that's a nice idea.
Is this selfish? Frank is where he is and I'm redecorating.
What are you supposed to do? Pace and be miserable? Your life goes on too.
Yeah, I guess.
Look, Frank is where he wants to be, even with the danger.
So, in your kitchen, when I saw Michael, what was that?
Oh, he was just preoccupied.
No, it was more than that. Claudia Joy, I felt like there was a big scarlet A being burned into my forehead.
I accidentally told you.
Accidentally?
You think I would do it on purpose?
Well, I don't know how it just suddenly came
up. Okay, he and Frank talk. He was acting like he knew, and it just came out, and I couldn't get it back. Believe me, I felt terrible. Denise, I'm your friend. I understand, but did you really expect there not to be any fallout over this?
No, what I expected.
Michael's entitled to his own feelings, right? There's nothing I can do to change his mind. To be honest, I'm worried too about where this is all going.
Yeah, so am I.
Wherever it goes, know I'm with you.
And I appreciate that.
So, I hate to disappoint Claudia Joy with the calendar, but Chase doesn't think it's a good idea that I put my face out there right now. And I kind of agree.
Well, I'm sure she'll understand, but...
But what?
Does it make sense to go into hiding? I mean, the odds of it happening again are pretty slim.
I'm not hiding, I'm just laying low.
I just hate to see him win, that's all.
Yeah.
Oh, hey, I thought that was you.
Hey, Jennifer, how's it going?
Great, settling down.
This is Roxy, she's in the FRG too. She just missed the meeting this morning. This is Jennifer Connor.
Oh, hey, my husband Trevor works for Colonel Connor temporarily.
I know, I heard all about him. So, you girls getting ready for the photo shoot? Picking out your wardrobe?
Actually, I'm gonna leave that to you guys.
The pinup idea was better, wasn't it?
Excuse me?
Claudia Joy's really smart and put together, but she's somewhat on the conservative side. Kind of took the air out of the whole thing.
Well, we all voted.
Like anybody's gonna say no to her.
Claudia Joy is one of our best friends.
Oh, I don't mean to offend. I like her. I really do.
And my reasons for not participating are totally different.
Sure they are. Look, I get it. I'm a lawyer. I understand politics.
It's not really politics.
Never explain, never complain. That's what I say.
I'll have a Caesar salad, doll. And this way to the ladies' room?
Uh-huh. I so have to do that calendar now.
Yeah, you do. Doll.
Doll.
You do realize this is the first time we've gone to bed together in over a week.
I do.
Talk to me.
I feel like you're on her side.
Hmm? There aren't any sides.
I didn't say I was proud of what I was feeling.
She was a single mother, just barely getting by. You're a doctor. I'm an officer in the army. Don't you think she might be a little intimidated? Maybe she just wants to prove herself.
As a shrink, I know it's a lot of defense and projection. As a son, it just feels like disapproval. Maybe a little payback. I was embarrassed that she worked in the school cafeteria. I didn't want to go in there with my friends. More than once, I denied knowing her.
You were just a kid.
Why did I think becoming a father would change all that history?
Give it some time. Maybe she wants to prove that she's still important. Let her teach you something. Wouldn't hurt you to do that, would it?
I guess we'll find out.
I mean, that's pretty.
This is pretty.
Hey,
out on the town there.
Hey, I thought you weren't coming.
Change of heart.
Oh, good. Are you sure?
Absolutely. What's a slice like without me?
There you go. Everyone's there.
What's this one? This is sweet.
16 military wines. 32 softly focused, brightly colored eyes.
And collapse.
Good. I'll see you soon.
Good night.
Denise.
Michael, don't you think we should talk?
I wouldn't know what to say.
Well, could you for a moment consider that maybe the situation is not so simple? It's not just an army wife being shallow and restless.
I believe that, Denise, I do. I'm sure whatever it is runs deep. And believe me, I'm struggling with my own reaction, but it all comes back to this. When men put their lives on the line, what goes on at home needs to be very simple. Fidelity. Loyalty, security. It's what you agreed to give him so that he could stay focused and do his job.
Well, what about what he agreed to give me?
That's between you and Frank.
You know what, Michael? It's all between me and Frank.
Beers, light them up.
I don't think that's such a great idea.
Hey, fellas, it's
a family place. Ease up. Giving that one guy three beers in an hour.
They're young.
Yeah, well, they're young and driving.
Cold catching up with you, huh?
Got a cold, allergies.
Roxy, no offense, but you look like death warmed over.
Look, I'm short-handed here, and Trevor has his Adapsy meeting in the morning. That means I got the early shift with the boys, so I cannot have a cold.
Apparently, your body didn't get that memo.
I'm fine. Hey, guys, come on. I warned you. Keep it down.
Sorry.
Can I get another beer?
No, you cannot have another beer. And if you keep that up, I'm taking the keys.
What?
Look, I'm responsible for anybody driving out of here. Just give me your keys.
It's okay.
Did I ask you? Now give me your keys.
Lost.
It's okay. He's just having a good time tonight.
A good time? I'm up to my neck in other people's good times.
No,
getting drunk and losing control, that's not good times. And you know what the problem is? It's never your fault. What about the people who have to pick up the tab for that, huh? What about their good times? You don't even care about the people who you leave in your path.
Look, I'm driving them, and I'm not drunk.
Get out! What are y'all looking at?
How you feeling?
I have a cold.
No kidding. Hey, Rox. What happened at the bar?
I know. I was over the top.
People who grow up with addictions, they develop their own addictions. It's called enabling.
You know, I was hoping the first five addicts I hooked up with were just a coincidence. Trevor was different. I was sure I'd broken the cycle.
Trevor is different. This is situational. But the way in which you're handling it is not. Glossing over problems, taking on more than you can do, not admitting defeat. That's the pattern. I assume you've heard of Al-Anon.
Yeah, I know about it. I was hoping I wouldn't need it. You know, when I was young, I used to wonder all the time when help was coming. And then one day I realized, oh, it's not. I'm on my own. Just stopped thinking about help, let alone asking for it.
But now things are different.
Yes, they are.
Yes. Mm-hmm. These are really good.
I'd hope you'd be pleased.
Mm-hmm.
Somehow I thought I'd be skinnier and younger.
You're all beautiful. The calendar's gonna be great.
What are you supposed to say? We're paying you.
Hey, what are these?
Oh, those are Mrs. Connor's shots. Sorry. I don't know how they ended up in the mix. They're supposed to be in a separate pile.
What are you talking about? We're all doing the same calendar.
Well, I thought you knew. Mrs. Connor commissioned a whole other kind of thing. She's doing a glamour project.
She's what?
She said it was a separate project. She's paying for it herself.
A competing calendar? Okay, now can we not like her? Hey. What happened here?
Well, it was supposed to be a home run in the other direction, but I'm afraid your children are not going to make the Olympic softball team, Pamela.
Well, then they'll just have to be astronauts. Listen, can I talk to you for a second?
Uh-oh.
I participated in that, calendar.
Why?
Because I just can't walk around scared all the time.
I don't like us taking risks with our family, Pamela.
I know, but look, you're drawn to me for a reason. Because I can take care of myself. I mean, you liked that part of me.
I did, and I still do.
You're off protecting our freedoms, and here I am, afraid to even be part of my own community. What's the use?
You make a good point, Officer Moran.
Mama's gonna buy you a mockingbird. You got the magic touch.
It's nothing. I just tell her what's going on.
Does that make a difference?
Sure it makes a difference. Most people think babies are stupid. Mainly when they get here, they're just confused. I mean, imagine how it feels. Not knowing from one minute to the next what's going on. I just tell her. She understands. And I know that's not in your books.
Well, maybe my books don't know everything. Show me.
I just say, you're going to sleep. And when you wake up, we will all be here.
Can I try?
You want to say.
Thank you for coming, Sarah Elizabeth. You too.
Patience, your strength. Everything that makes you a great father.
Is this the right address?
Yes, it is. I did some research. Best place in town.
You want a tattoo?
It's on my list.
Why?
I don't know. I want to do something scary and permanent. A ritual, a rite of passage.
Do you have something in mind? What's this mean?
Well, it's Sanskrit for a beautiful mistake. The idea that nothing is really a mistake, that every choice is a lesson that shapes who we are, who we become. I don't ever want to forget that.
I don't want you to either.
Now I'm down. Hanging on the corner.
I only knew my wife a couple of weeks before I married her. Now, a lot of people would call that irresponsible, but I just knew. I knew she was the one.
I made one impulsive choice after another because that's all I saw the people around me do. But for some reason, choosing Trevor was the right thing. It led me to sanity, and I can't forget that. I can't run away at the first sign of trouble, but I also can't deny what's all around me either. I owe it to him.
It's like,
to our children.
It's like there's something bigger. You know, like this, this small voice that we can barely hear, trying to tell us what we need to do.
The truth is in the middle, in the quiet.
We just have to listen.
I'm learning to be still.
Thanks for letting me share.
Thank you for letting me share.
Parade.